lack of affordable housing is a problem for many Americans, but for adults with disabilities, it's on the verge of becoming a disaster. That's according to the nonprofit group The Arc. They warn there are nearly a million intellectually or developmentally disabled people who are living with a caregiver who's 60 years old or older. And as those caregivers age, many worry the adult children risk being institutionalized or becoming homeless. The warning comes as a massive wave of children with autism, about 500,000, will reach adulthood within the next decade. And as our correspondent Jessica Gomez tells us, in many parts of the country, parents are now taking matters into their own hands.
In a small coffee shop in rural Mount Horeb, Wisconsin, this group of parents has become a fixture, meeting here every Tuesday for the past 6 years.
Our brochures, hot off the press.
At the helm, friends for more than two decades, Marianne Omakin and Susan Wallach. Like the others here, they share a common bond, children with disabilities.
Did you want pee?
Susan's son, 27-year-old Frankie.
Cut up.
And Marianne's daughter, 25-year-old Amy. Both have severe autism. The conversations about their children's future started long ago when they were in preschool.
We know that she's going to continue to require that 24/7 care for the rest of her life. And so it was always the worry in the back of our minds, what is that going to look like?
In their nearby rural communities, like many places across the country, they say there are few affordable and available options.
All right, shall we go? We'll do a little more lesson. When I had cancer, I wasn't afraid of dying myself. I was afraid of who is going to take care of my son. And that's what I would lay in the hospital thinking about. You know, how will Frankie be cared for? Who is going to do all the things for him that he needs that I do for him?
It's a beautiful spot.
The moms are now one step closer to answering those questions. With help from a nonprofit Wisconsin developer and federal tax credits, this rural land in New Glarus will soon be the site of an integrated housing complex. A portion will go to special needs adults like Amy and Frank. The rest for those earning $22 an hour or less, or seniors on a fixed income. Rent will start at about $400 a month.
It's going to be more than just an apartment where you walk in and close your door. It's going to be a real community of people.
And this is the front entrance.
Since news broke of what the grassroots group of parents is accomplishing, calls are pouring in from around the country. Other parents desperate for help.
There are stories after stories after stories about children with autism, and those stories need to be heard, right? But these children grow up, and that first big wave of children with autism, when that spike started to happen, well, those young people are now in their mid to late 20s, early 20s. I think it's, frankly, a public health crisis, and it's an affordable housing crisis.
The country will see a wave of homelessness for people with autism and developmental disabilities. It's coming.
In Richmond, Virginia, parents Don and Lynn Fazen founded the Fazen Center for Autism 20 years ago. Back then, there wasn't much help for their daughter, Brittany.
It's up to the parents to figure out what to do with these children.
Once just a school, they've now added adult housing, where those like 23-year-old Matthew Bowles can live on their own.
Well, I was able to learn like how to be able to cook on my own and be able to clean things around the apartment.
There's such a great need, and people need help, and there's nobody helping educate them. And the whole thing changes when they turn adults.
Technology like motion sensors, ovens that turn off automatically, and cameras focused on the front door helps keep those like Matthew safe, yet independent.
In the perfect world, there are housing options for the entire spectrum. That's the problem right now across the country, is there are no options. And people are trying to shoehorn adults with autism into other housing situations that just don't work.
I just can't believe we're here now. It's a great transformation.
His new life, a relief for Matthew's mom.
I feel bad for her knowing that she was worried.
Bless your heart. He's so sweet.
Absolutely gorgeous.
And back in Wisconsin, there's less worry for mom Susan and Marianne, as a vision 20 years in the making will soon become reality.
I can't wait to see what's going to happen here, how the community is going to grow, and what's what will come out of this.
In New Glarus, Wisconsin, for Matter of Fact, I'm Jessica Gomez.
According to the CDC, it costs about $17,000 more per year to care for a child with autism spectrum disorder. Many nonprofit groups like Autism Speaks have financial planning tools that are available on their websites.